Editor's note real quick. Yes, I am the wizard, but it is my fault. The podcast has kind of ceased. I am working really hard finishing school. Travis is about to have a kid, but we should be resuming hopefully normally soon. But in the meantime, I am greatly appreciative of all your support, and please ignore the terrible quality. You'll see. I dropped the ball.
I'm gonna talk and stuff with my face and my mouth is moving and my lips slings and junk and stuff, and here we go. I'm gonna make some sounds with my mouth and talk more loudly and is this a prank? I feel like I'm being punked right now.
There we go.
And 5, 4, 3, 2.
Hey, y'all. Travis from Realm About After Dark, or the podcast. We're not filming the podcast. This is just going to be an After Dark bit. We're sorry to make you guys wait so long, but the podcast is still on hiatus, but we thought we'd take some time to watch the one episode of Darkplace we don't have up on our channel.
100% my fault. So
you got life and things to do. You have responsibility. We all do. I barely even have enough time for my main channel. Speaking of which, it's doing pretty good. Check it out. It's the Realm About Fantasy. If you guys are starved for content, I still upload content on my main channel. You ready to watch this? He's working some stuff out. That's what that means, the thing he's doing. This is as good as it's going to get.
All hey, right. Creators of Darkplace, can you release an HD version?
That would be amazing.
The moonlight shone down on the place unhindered. The gnarled parapets jagged upwards like a bony hand of icy indifference. In the background, there was a pigeon.
In the background.
I don't remember this at all.
40 years? 50 years? Tempus immemoria, i.e. always?
An example, i.e.
A very bad place indeed.
So dumb. In the background, there was a pigeon.
Greetings, traveler. Who am I? Perhaps you have met me twixt sleep and wake. In the penumbra of uncertainty you call unconsciousness. Or perhaps you've met me at a book signing. I'm Garth Marenghi, horror author. My business is chill, pure and simple. You know, my books are all essentially about what-ifs. In Blackfang, I asked, what if a rat could drive a bus? And what if it and its rat brethren took over and ate Parliament? When I wrote, directed, and starred in tonight's episode of Garth Marenghi's Dark Place, I was asking another what if. Now, I won't tell you which what if it is, but it's basically along the same lines but with a different animal. Without giving too much away, think Planet of the Apes. This Eve's Tale of Blood is an allegory. And as such, I've included interviews with myself, my publisher, Dean Lerner, and the actor, Todd Rivers, so that we can tell you what it means. Here it be, a future shot that'll shit you up. I'd like to dedicate tonight's episode to my wife, Pam, who deals with the bulk of my admin.
Admin? Apparently that is an actual Channel 4 animation that they used in like the 80s or something, and they repurposed it for this show to make it feel like it was made in the 80s.
That's hilarious.
Yeah. There's a lot of lore to this show, inside and outside the show.
These intros are just insane.
I have an idea. This is what they should do. This show should get rebooted with Jack Black as Garth.
There you go. Now, you gotta bring back the original cast.
Oh, God, yeah.
Sanch, are you copping Z's? Come on, I need you on the ward. There are kids dying.
I need a show clip.
Just give me two ticks. My mouth feels like somebody parked a car in it.
Why is it green? I don't care.
That's peculiar.
Sanj! Sanj?
What? Whoa, that was fast.
I don't remember this episode at all. What the fuck is happening? The Apes of Wrath. God.
That I realized how radical Darkplace was and is. We knew at the time it was raw, but we didn't realize it could get rawer with time. It's balls to the wall, flat out horror.
They would not make this show today. They would not make it. You know, it was way the hell out there. You know, we were young, we were physically fit, and we were challenging logic.
Challenging logic.
My name is Dr. Rick Dagless, MD. A new terror in Darkplace. Sanchez, my friend, my buddy, is now
my buddy.
Although still a competent surgeon, he does now smell like an ape. But was he the only one? Well, the word on the
his
ward was
car
no.
Fucking he sucks, dude. Yeah.
This place was dark.
It's the dumbest shit.
I can't get over. They're already at the hospital. They have to drive
the wheels and haul ass to Reed's office. But on the
to
way,
another fucking place just
talk.
To go back in the same fucking hospital.
Hey there, little boy. Yeah, why were they good driving news. Anywhere? What? Right. That doesn't make any sense.
Those prescription drugs you couldn't afford. I bought them out of my own pocket. Don't thank me. I've got to go and save another life. Take care, little guy.
Okay.
Dr. Dagless.
Yes, buddy.
I owe you everything. If you need any help, you could always rely on me.
That means a lot.
Why is there creepy clowns in that room?
Because it's for little kids, I guess, and they think kids like clowns.
I punched one of the child actors who was working on set because they were rude about Garth writing. It's more of a back of the hand than a punch. But they came up in a big red bruise. Someone took a photo of it, blah, blah, blah. Cry, cry, cry. I don't see it as a problem.
Jim, could you run these ECG results past the boys in radiology?
Right away.
Dang. In here.
Oh, don't even have time to drink
the
this.
Delay. He went to drink it and stopped before he said anything.
It's certainly an improvement on the old look.
Hey. Morning, Dad. Morning, Thornton Reed.
Good morning.
Would either of you two like a glass of water?
No, thanks. I'll have a coffee.
Thanks, Sanj. I'd love a glass.
Oh, drat. It's run out. Here, have mine.
No, Sanj. You have it. I'll grab a coffee instead of the water.
One coffee coming right up. Here you go.
Cheers.
All styrofoam and plastic.
As I'm sure you people are aware, we've got a situation. People are regressing to a primal stage, and it's spreading. Fast. Douglas, we need a slice of your life. What's going on?
I figure the following. Sanchez regressing to Homo neanderthalensis. Right now, Sanchez, you're Homo erectus, but who knows how long you've got.
I appreciate you being straight with me.
And you and I are Homo sapiens.
Correct.
But if we're all basically homos, shouldn't we get along?
You'd fool. But Homo erectus is famed for his meanness. How are you feeling in here, Sanchez?
I'm bearing up, you know me, Dag.
Yeah. Yeah, I do, big guy.
Come on, you two queers. We need to lift this problem before it turns round and slaps us in the nuts. We
holy
need data.
Shit,
Liz,
how the fuck
pull us boys in, if you'll pardon the expression. Liz?
Liz?
Liz!
It's called Liz, too.
Whatever it is.
Dr. Sanchez, if you don't come to surgery now, we'll have to start without you.
Wish me luck.
Good luck.
Still gonna let him perform surgery.
I need to crack this, Dad, because if not, one tunnel will be all over me like knockers in a wind tunnel.
I'll go and have a look with the padre. He knows a lot about monkeys.
Right, I'll stay here.
Come on.
That was weird.
I led Liz, by now a sick parody of womanhood, down the corridor. Perhaps the Padre could elucidate the cause of all this. Though at this stage in the narrative, it would be odd if he did.
No! This makeup was done years ago for the monkeys. I was worried when I saw the VHS again that it would look ridiculous and old-fashioned, you know, and quite naff. It's not true. It looks great, still.
I'm losing it. This show is just fucking ridiculous.
Would you like a drink of something? Tea? Coffee? Juice?
I'd love a glass of water.
No! That's mine.
Well, don't sweat it. I'll suck them in. I'll come straight to the point.
Where does the church
There's water coolers everywhere.
Monkeys were created by God to entertain us. That's all we know, Rick.
But sure.
That's all we know, Rick!
Yeah. Sure, Padre. I think I understand. Come on, Liz.
Mind how you go, Rick.
That's all we know!
Mind how you go.
What the fuck?
It worsens. The Padre, my friend and colleague, is now an ape. Who was next? Would it get me? I really hoped it wouldn't. And what was it, anyway? So many questions. Why Liz? Why the Padre? Why Sanchez? Why not Reed? Why not me? This hospital was turning into a jungle, and everyone was acting like monkeys.
Terry, run a J over the seat. I think Liz has left a souvenir.
Emergency and surgery.
Okay.
Not my fault, monkey bastard hands.
It wasn't difficult for me to get into character. I mean, I know the beast in me. I've been drunk with him for 15 years. it was home from home, you might say.
Both Todd and I were wild at the time. I mean, we were behaving like flipping Romans. We were like animals. And I looked in the mirror one day. Excuse me. And I said, you're not a man, Dean. You're an ape.
I had stood in Dean's front room and watched him make a lot of love. Just to say that.
I'm afraid of what I'm becoming. Yeah, that's me.
Oh my God.
I used to have the best head in the hospital.
What?
I'm starting to get some pretty primal urges.
I didn't want to say, but when I went into surgery this morning, you were waving your bits out the window.
I don't even know I'm doing it. I thought I was helping attach a drip. I went to the Padre to confess. Ended up washing my ass in the font.
Liz is throwing her own poo as a way of getting attention.
If I get too far gone, Rick, you know what to do.
Yeah. Well, you hang on in there, bud. You hang on in there for Rick.
Oh. Damn. Where do you get that club?
I fell into a strange fantastical dream, rich in imaginative imagery. I found myself alone in a primitive land
rich
where
in
phantasms
imaginative.
Spelt with a PH, not an F, abounded. I turned one
PH, not an F.
Then the other. Then back. Then forward. Then I saw myself as a monkey.
Oh. What the hell? A premonition?
So it looked like it was suing
out. My head felt like a plum without the pip. Apparently, I'd been asleep.
I think
for
I
a
must
month,
have missed whatever
ages.
You saw.
Reed told me everything. How the monkeys now ruled Darkplace. How they've taken over.
They've taken over.
What the fuck? How long was he out?
Oh Jesus! They've taken over. They've taken over.
I know.
Love it.
The guggling sound is ridiculous.
The clan rejected her. She'd been mauled when I found her. The brutes.
What are we going to do, Reed?
Blow me if I know. God, my throat is parched. I'd best have a sip of water.
Jesus.
That wasn't water.
Look, Dag. Maybe we shouldn't do anything.
What do you mean?
I mean, this hospital's running pretty well, despite all this.
What do you mean?
No one takes days off anymore, everyone's grooming each other, and the doctors are literally working for peanuts. Within a year, our financial problems will be history. Old news. We'll be able to build that children's wing. Think about it, Rick. The Darkplace Dagless Kiddie Wing. It's what we've always dreamed about.
Not this way, Dagless. Wade. It's barbaric. I want that kiddie wing just as much as you do. But right now, most of those kids are chimps, and that's my priority.
You're a fool! You're a fool to walk away from this! You're a fool! 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 You're a fool. You're a flipping fool! You're a fool!
Rather than you two like a glass of water.
I don't even have time to drink this water, Umber.
I'll grab a coffee instead of the water.
Would you like a drink of something?
I don't even have time to drink this water, Umber. It's the water, the water, the water, the water, the water, the water.
I still haven't had a glass of water. Wait a minute, it is the water.
Don't drink that. Look, it's bright green.
Thank God I only took a tiny sip.
Someone or something has been tampering with our water supply. I'm going to the water store. I have a hunch that whoever or whatever he or she or it is will be in there.
Right, I'll stay here and try and recuperate as fast as I can.
What?
2, 3, 4, 5.
That's a fat fucking 44 Magnum just in his pocket.
Why do they always have
the reason? Reed survives is that I only take a tiny sip. There's that line, thank God I only took a tiny sip. And if you take a tiny sip of this, you're all right.
I know writers who use subtext and they're all cowards. Okay? What I was asking in that scene is, what if politicians continue to pay doctors peanuts? Could they literally turn into monkeys? And no one's asked that before.
Subtext is for cowards. Jeez. Got a lot of water. Jesus. They just fucking photocopy fucking water on boxes. Why do they have this much storage for water?
See the fucking the fucking camera. Oh my god.
Water, water everywhere. And not a drop to drink. Coleridge. Samuel D.
Oh, it's piss?
I don't think that's piss.
Fiendish fount of this fear, an apoloid, micturating, which means urinating, on my erstwhile, which means former, buddy. I had a hunch this guy was the head honcho.
Oh, he's out of bullets. Oh. Oh, so much for continuity.
What continuity? This whole fucking show lacks it.
What? Playing motor sounds? That's hilarious.
Oh! I remember the bike chase scene.
I vaguely remember it. I think I remember it going on for way too long.
Yeah, fucking done it.
With the shit camera work. Was that a stunt double?
I think it was. I think it was.
The quality is so bad I can't tell.
Oh my god.
Hold on, lost your bat there. Jesus. You know me, Dag? I'm too busy just staying alive. Oh man, this is so intense. What's that ramp there?
Holy hell. Is that another stunt double?
Yeah, that was definitely not him there. What the fuck? There was clearly something underneath him.
He was walking.
Yeah.
Why is there water? They totally did that at some fucking public park.
If you use antiperspirant, it clogs up your pores. If you clog up your pores, you're going to sweat elsewhere. On your tongue, under your ears, on the forehead, and if you block all those areas with antiperspirant, you're going to get a breath problem. And that's just, that's fact. That's scientific fact. And if you block up everything, well, then you're going to sweat inside and get cancer.
I don't think any of that is true.
That witch died in my arms out there should
fucking
never have
cried. It was still, it was so fucking was so good. It's so bad, but it's half-formed and hell-bent on
dragging us back into the Stone Age.
Could you give us a detailed explanation as to why all this happened?
He was once a scientist who specialized in human evolution and had worked hard on it for many years. At some stage during his research, he discovered he was able to access mankind's atavistic tendencies and harness them for his own malevolent schemes. He developed a serum extracted from the gonads of gibbons, which when passed through the balls of chimps at light speed in a special atomic container, could turn men into monkeys. He then
the
set
balls.
About contaminating our very own water supply. So I've had to buy an antidote, which is why everyone is now back to normal.
Thankfully, he didn't succeed.
Well, I think we all saw the beastliness this last week.
True enough, but if you boys make another crack about my taking a shit in Dag's car, I'll give you the thick end of the wedge.
Okay, Liz, no need to go away.
Hey, I thought I told you.
She's going bananas.
I think that's literally a kid diaper on his head.
A diaper?
Like one of those old-fashioned, like, button ones that are fat
weird.
It is
funny. It is funny.
We laughed to protect ourselves, to mask the awful horror. Although I thought what Reed said about Liz going bananas was genuinely witty. Each man must acknowledge his beast, whether through sport or violent films. But a man must not let his beast be his master. Otherwise, you know better than Bill Wyman.
Love it.
Okay. Ooh. I remember the bike chase scene a little bit. I remembered a little bit of the monkey spunk, but
I've always been good with words. She was like a zoo in a woman.
I don't think anyone will get an animal impersonator like her again.
It's so hard to watch this episode, knowing that she's now missing, presumed dead, with the presumption heavily on dead. I don't think they'll find anything.
What the fuck?
But then again, she was like a candle in the wind. Unreliable.
I was talking to her, I had a lock, and suddenly I heard a voice. Come here, and it was madly.
All I'm picturing is Venom at that point, like a turd. She said, in the wind. Like a candle in the wind, unreliable.
And she said, that's inelegant. And then very quietly she went. And I lit a joss stick and prayed.
The years, you never let me down.
Who's in every episode after this? Wait a minute.
No, I mean, the commentary that they're making is supposed to take place years after filming. So it still makes logical sense that she'd still be in. Not that logic really matters to these people.
Holy shit.
She's probably somewhere in the Eastern Bloc. That's my hunch.
Do you think she's still alive then?
No, I think she's probably just buried in the Eastern Bloc. If she got a burial.
Jesus.
Garth Marenghi's Dark Place is a Garth Marenghi production.
I don't remember that at all. Like a candle in the wind.
Unreliable.
Unreliable. Okay, that is actually probably the funniest episode.
I'd have to rewatch. I think based off my fleeting memory, the first episode is still my favorite and made me laugh the most. But we should rewatch the series, but like do a live stream where they he like
falls.
Oh my god. True. I think in the final episode Dean implies that like every episode has taken place within a single week. Because he's like, when you opened that portal last week, I remember this. So my babysitter, I had this babysitter. She used to show me these.
This is as bad as Dark Place. I kind of want to watch it.
Began to change his life. And at last, Miles Peterson felt the burning desire to know God, inspired by the word of God. And equipped with unyielding faith, Miles pledged to fight evil in the name of God. And Bible Man.
Let's go.
What the Okay, I'm down to watch this, but goddamn, it looks fucking. It's not fucking lightsaber!
Bible Man!
What the Power Ranger shit is going on? Reminds me of.
That was rad as fuck.
What is it called?
That was metal.
Jay and Silent Bob.
That's
literally.
Yes. Like the what's his name? Knuckle Buster.
Cock knocker.
Oh my god!
And it was actually Mark Hamill. They actually got Mark. Goodbye. Have a wonderful day. Drink your water and always like, subscribe, share the videos, and please head over to Travis's. Main channel, as the Realm About podcast is not our main channels. His is Realm About. He is a wonderful gamer, wonderful new father that's coming in, so please subscribe and share the content. Make us rich or I'll give you the plosive penis.
Here's the deal, though. In all honesties, I just want to make enough money so I can spend the summer with my son. That's it. I just don't want a summer job. I want to spend the whole summer with my newborn son. That's all. That's it. You can support me by buying my book.
Do you have maternity leave at your work?
No.
Anyways, have a wonderful day. I'm going to probably go through and cut out a lot of this because I was cussing up a storm.
All right. Peace, y'all. Love you.